วัสดีค่ะ
สวัสดีเจ้า Welcome back to
Thai Girl Talk.
This is episode 2.
Yes.
Right.
With you need to say who you are.
I know, I keep forgetting. episode 2, forgive me. My name is Mia
and I'm Lonnie.
Okay. Well, we have to get used to that, introducing ourselves every time in every episode. So Lonnie, last episode we're talking about hello and goodbye, right? Today I picked a really, really important subject. Now this is how you ask the question in Thai. Well, let's just say the word first. Mai.
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 This is rising tone. This is the formal and the correct way of pronouncing this word. But in a spoken Thai, sometimes it's become mai.
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 Change to high tone. Let's put into the sentence, shall we? Lani, kao jai mai.
Kao jai ka.
Yes, kao jai mean understand. So I asked Lani, Lani, do you understand?
Uh-huh.
And Lani answer as?
Kao jai ka.
That's right. So you use the verb of the questions as the answer.
Okay.
Let's see another example. Lani, hiu mai.
Hiu ka.
Right, it's past midday now. Hiu means hungry. So I asked Lani, Lani, hungry?
Mm-hmm.
And Lani say, hiu ka. That's right. Now Lani, you can keep your answer short by say, ka.
Ka.
Ka can be yes.
Ka.
Same thing as crap as well.
Oh yes.
So if you like, you want to keep your answer short, you just say ka, ka, ka. Or crap, crap, crap.
Mm-hmm.
And same time, when you listen to a Thai telling you a story, a long story, and you just want to say that, okay, I'm still listening to you,
mm-hmm.
you say ka.
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 Mm-hmm,
ka.
In English, you say like, yeah, yes.
Yes, we do this too.
Right. Thai is the same. Okay. Now, sometimes you might hear young people or people in the same age, they talk to each other. Lani, we are friends. Come on, stop being ka all the time. It's too polite. I know you well.
Ja.
Ja. Right. Ja. It's also similar to ka and crap as well. It's the form of polite particle, which you can add at the end of your question, sentence. Ja. Informal.
So do boys and girls say ja?
Boy can use ja only when he speaks with a girl.
Oh, okay. So boys and boys do not use ja.
No, they use mm. Well, this is and is not really polite. Okay, just remarked on that. But you might hear it when you're speaking amongst friends.
Yes.
Okay. Then the next is chai mai.
Chai mai.
Chai mai.
Chai mai.
Then the informal chai mai is chai mai, chai mai.
Chai mai.
That's right. And you probably have heard these songs. These three girls, they are singing and then they say, chimmy, 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 chimmy. It took me quite a while to really know that they are talking about chai mai. So, chai mai, what does that mean, chai mai? Chai mai is, you use this chai mai when you're not sure about the information that you have. For example, Lani, someone told me that you are not 100% Thai, but I have this information in my mind, and I meet you one day, and I say, Lani, you're not really Thai, chai mai?
Mm-hmm.
Now I want you to confirm my understanding. Am I correct or am I not correct?
Chai ka.
So Lani, kun ben kon Thai, chai mai?
Mai chai ka.
Mai chai, that's right. Mai chai means it's not correct. So Lani, tell me like what I understood is not correct. She said mai chai.
Mai chai.
Mai chai, that's right. So let's say one more. Lani, you like spicy food? Chai mai?
Chai ka.
That's really good. Chai ka, she likes spicy food. So why am I asking this? What's the difference between chai mai and mai? one more time. If I'm gonna say, Lani, do you like spicy food? ไหม? Now this means the answer could be yes or no, 50% or 50%. I have no idea about Lani, but when I use ใช่ไหม, I'm kind of guess in my mind that mm-hmm. your answer will be yes.
Okay, so it's a confirmation.
Exactly, the confirmation question.
So you're like 90% sure of the mm-hmm. answer?
Right, and
okay.
you just want to make sure that you're right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so because Lani is half Thai, so I'm assuming that she likes spicy food. So once again, Lani ชอบเผ็ดใช่ไหม
ใช่ค่ะ
ดีมากค่ะ really well. Lani, I'm sure that you understand how to say yes in Thai.
ค่ะ
ค่ะ that's right ค่ะ well Thai tend to say ค่ะ yes even mm-hmm. though maybe they could mean no
oh
right so sometimes it's not easy to admit if you don't understand something
right that's true
yeah so if I ask you Lani do you know this place you know like oh it's so famousAnd actually, Lani doesn't really know, but...
Oh, dear.
but Lani don't want to be like, oh, you're a village girl, you know nothing about this. So Lani say, yeah, of course I know this place.
Right. Chai.
Chai, mm-hmm, ka. But this is a lot to do with Thai culture that we tend to save face. So talking about save face, you need to know this word, xia na.
เสียหน้า
mean losing face.
Ah.
So the word เสีย is really interesting. เสีย means something is not working, is not function. For example,
broken.
Right. Computer เสีย.
Mm-hmm.
So my computer is not working or is broken. รถ เสีย.
Motorcycle เสีย.
Motorcycle เสีย. So you เสียหน้า.Which means you're losing face.
Broken face.
Right. use broken face. And so Thai, we kind of like, what can I say? It's not easy to admit if we do something wrong.
Mm-hmm.
It's hard to say sorry.
yep.
And I'm sure with different culture as well, right?
Some people, absolutely.
Yeah. So to save your face, you always say,ค่ะ ใช่ mm-hmm, that's right but so be aware of that you know when you're talking to a Thai and they seems to understand everything you said ค่ะ mm-hmm. crap on everything but they might not want to admit that they actually don't get what you're saying like เข้าใจไหม
เข้าใจค่ะ
I don't think she understand but she's saying it because maybe she just doesn't want to talk about it anymoreOr she's just saving her face.
Yeah, that's a really good point, especially when tourists or people or foreigners are visiting and they tell the tuk-tuk or mm-hmm. the red truck, right? You guys say rot dang in the...
Rot dang, that's rot-dang. Correct. Rot dang.
But in Bangkok, they say song tao.
Song tao. Yes, the people who come from central Thailand, they tend to say song tao.
Oh, okay.
Song mean two.Number two, mm-hmm. and tail mean row. So two rows.
Okay.
Two rows on the side of the pickup, so that's the seat, right?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So song tail, or Chiang Mai people will call rot dang.
Yeah, red truck.
Because it's really red.
Hard to miss, because my students, they would correct me. Oh, we say rot dang here.
That's right, we don't say song tail.
So I think...Don't get frustrated. I know it's hard when you want to get back to your hotel or you see something like a different Watt and maybe the driver wants to save face and we'll say he understands or mm-hmm. he knows where he's going.
Right.
And he doesn't.
Oh, that's happened all the time.
Yeah.
Oh, by like, let's say like Holiday Inn hotel and he might say, oh, yes, I know where it is.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But maybe he's just not sure where it is. He guessed he knew.
Right, or he'll call his friends and ask. Or,
right.
Yeah, or he has an idea of where the Holiday Inn is.
Right, exactly. So especially if you have to admit that you don't understand or you don't know something with someone who's younger than you because you are an adult.
Mm.
You happen to know best. And imagine if you have to admit that, oh, I have no idea how to use this iPad, but let's keep pretending I know how to use it. Or they could be like, I'm not interested.
Mm-hmm.
Even though they do curious about what is this iPad thing, but they would not even touch it because
they don't know.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And they don't want to lose face, like, oh, you just don't know how to use it. So yeah, it's not easy to be an adult.
It's true.
Right. You have to keep up with all these new technologies, and my mom is the same way. But well, when you are close relationship with someone, let's say me and my mom, she doesn't have to care about losing face, right? Because she's my mom. She has nothing to lose.
Right.
But if you meet someone and you just friend but not really close, you want to be, you want to look your best.
Yes.
You want people to see you that, oh, she's great. But hey, and the more you get to know, you might not be that perfect. Okay.
So be understanding, be patient. That is definitely part of the Thai culture.
Exactly. Yes. So if you want to make sure if they understand what you're saying, you can say, Khao jai mai? Right? Khao jai means understand.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so you say something, you say, Khao jai mai? So if the yes is like, softly, you can guess that maybe not.
Right, so much of language is body language.
Exactly, yes, you have to read the body language as well. And to only learn Thai, speak Thai is not enough. You have to understand the culture and the behavior of people as well.
Yes.
So it was fun, Lani.
Yeah, unfortunately, yes. We're out of time.
Yes, until the next episode, I hope you guys practice what you have learned. And if you have any questions, comments, anything, just drop everything here at the website, right?
Mm-hmm.
And we will be sure that we respond to all your questions.
All right.
Okay,
take care.
Hokkan mai ka.
โชคดีค่ะ
สวัสดีค่ะ
สวัสดีค่ะ